A Philippine symbol of a family seeking justice for two lives stolen. Two chicks sit atop the coffin of Francis Manosca, 6 years old, killed in his sleep, lying near his father, Domingo. There was a knock on the door, says Elizabeth Navarro. My husband said, "Who's that?" Then I heard two gunshots. By the time Navarro realized what was happening, her husband and son were dead, the gunman gone. She says her husband was an occasional drug user trying to get clean in what has become open season for anyone suspected of being tied to drugs. Married for 11 years, this mother of five, now a widow at 29.
You have a baby on the way. How do you go forward now?
I have nothing to do, she says, but try to go on with life. One day after these murders, Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte revealed he personally killed drug suspects while serving as mayor of his hometown.
But in Davao, I used to do it personally, just to show to the guys that if I can do it, why can't you? And I go around Davao with a motorcycle.
Nearly 6,000 people have died in the Philippines in less than 6 months. Police call more than half of those deaths vigilante-style killings. Many suspect police involvement, often little or no investigation. All of this openly encouraged by President Duterte. This woman too afraid to show her face. They're killing left and right, she says. Sometimes they kill 10 or 20 a day. I'm scared. These days, you don't know who's your enemy.
Public opinion polls show the majority of Filipinos support President Duterte's war on drugs. They say it makes their communities feel safer. But here in this neighborhood, we couldn't find a single person who says this number of killings is justified.
Even this woman who supports Duterte is afraid to speak openly. I hope that the government will give people a chance to change, she says, a chance for them to stop using illegal drugs.
No criminals.
Maria Musabia insists her son Domingo was not a thug or a dealer, but she admits his use of shabu or meth, a $3 high, may have gotten him killed. Just outside, they play cards to raise $900 for the funeral, three times her late son's yearly earnings as a bicycle taxi driver. This is just one Filipino family out of thousands, and promises by their president of even more killing to come. Will Ripley, CNN, Manila.